Welcome students, in this video we will discuss file handling using Python programming language. These are the contents that are there in our syllabus. Now what is the need for a data file? We need data file to store the data that is produced by our program. Then the types of files, data files. There are two types of data files. That we deal with in Python programming language, these are text files, binary files, and other one is comma separated value files. I can show you an example of comma separated value files. This is a file whose name is eggs2.csv. This is the file extension .csv. This is the text file, plain text file, in which values are separated by commas until the end of line is encountered, and so on. Then basic operations on the text file, then reading and manipulation of data from the text file, appending to the text file standard input output and error streams. Standard input, now what is the standard input? In our Python program we use input to got input from the user. Now we got input from the standard input. Now what is this standard input? In case of our Python program, the standard input is keyboard. In case of how we showed our output in Python program, we showed output using monitor. This is our standard output, and also the errors are showed on the monitor. This is the standard error streams. Then the binary files operations, read, write, search, append, update, etc. These are the CSV file operations. Then came the pickle module. I will try to cover each of these topics in this video. Then the types of data files, text file and binary file. We can open a file in Python using either a text file. We can open text file or binary files. When we open a file using text file, as a text file, we read from the text file strings and we write two strings to the text file. But when reading data from the text file, the platform specific line endings got converted to the new lines, and while writing data or string to the text file, the new lines got converted to platform specific line endings. These behind the scene character translations can corrupt our video, audio and images files. That's why while dealing with audio, video and music files, we generally use open them as binary files. I hope you got the point. Then these are the operations that we can use on the text file, and these are the operations again we will use on binary file. These are the modes by which we can open our file. First one is read mode. When we want only to read the data that is there in our file, we use the read mode. Write mode, when we only want to write the contents to the file, we will use write mode. And X is used when we want to create our file exclusively. Then A is for append mode. Append is also here to write data to the file, and write is also to write the contents to the file. Now what is the difference between append and write? Append will append the data at the end of the file. Suppose I opened a file which was previously having some data. Now when I open that file again using the append mode, when I write my content to data, the data got appended to the end of the file. But in the case of write mode, when I opened a file using write mode which already has some data, then the file content got overwritten. I hope you got this point. Binary mode and text mode. When we want to open the file as a binary file, we have to supplied B in addition to the read or write or append. But in case we don't want to open our file as a binary file, we need not explicitly give this T parameter, which is here there by default. Then plus can be used for updating. Use deprecated, we will not use this mode in our program. This is the signature of the open function. Now open is used to open all the files, and these are the various parameters. We have to supply the name of the file, and rest all are default parameters. As we can see, if we will not supply these parameters, mode, buffering, encoding, errors, new line, closed file descriptors, opener, etc., then these parameters got their default values. But we can supply the parameters if we want, as we want. Then there are two functions again. What does this tell function do? Tell function return the file object's current position. When suppose I had a file given, suppose I have this file, this text file. When the file is opened, the file object's current position would be at the first character. Here the first character is T. File object's current position. Suppose while reading or writing, the file object's current position is S. Now, what does this F dot tell would return? F dot tell returns the file object's current position. In case of binary file, it will return the number of bytes from the start of the file. Number of bytes from the start of the file to which it is pointing. But in case of text file, it will return an opaque number. Now, what does this f.seek function does? We all have seen the CD-DVD player, and in the CD-DVD players, we have seek forward and seek backward buttons. This seek function works like that, seek forward and seek backward. This is the offset. Offset specifies, offset can be positive or negative. Positive means moving forward, negative means moving backward. From and whence specifies from where. Whence is the reference point. It can be from the start of the file, which is represented by 0. And 1 is the current position of the file, where we are, and 2 specifies the end of the file. Then we will practice some codes. I can show you the codes. In this cell, I have opened a file named D1, which is opened in the write mode and is the text file. Why it is text file? Because I have not supplied B here. Now I opened a text file named D1, and this is the file handle. F is the file handle here. Now f.write. f.write is used to write the contents to the file. I have written this string to the file and I used f.close. f.close is to close the resources that are associated with this file. Now, after executing this cell, I got this b1 file content. Then in the next cell I again open the file b1 but in binary mode, read mode as a binary file. When I read this file, I got the content as the whole world is locked down due to COVID-19. But the line endings here got changed to carriage return and new line. This behind the scene character translation occurs in case of text files. To prevent these character translations, we use binary files. Now, I will show you the signature of this f.seek. This is the offset and this is the reference point, and 0 is here by default. If we will not supply here argument, it will be from the start of the file. 0 represents start of the file, 1 represent current position, then 2 represent end of the file. Then from here I have opened a file named b1 and I have not supplied any mode. Now the mode is read mode and the file is opened as a text file by default, and f is the file handle. And if I execute this code. Now I opened the file named b1 in the read mode as a text file. The file, this is the b1 file. Now the file object's current position would be at the start of the file, and the start of the file is pointing to t here. Now when I read, what does read do? Read the character in case of return string. Read return string in case of text file, and read returns bytes, number of bytes in case of binary file. Now read, when given some arguments, read how many characters to read. By executing this cell, what does I got? T. I got T when I read only one character. Then if I supplied this, then what I will got? I will got the whole string but except T. Why? Because T is consumed by this read one. And if read is not supplied any argument, read will read all the content of the file. It will return the content as string. And what does this f.seek? f.seek is file objects is rewinding the file's object's current position to the start of the file. And I am executing this, and now I am moved to this current position. Then suppose I execute this cell f.readline. Now readline, what will readline will do? Readline will read the line of the text file. Readline will read the text line t
till it encounter the new line. Suppose new line, here the new line is after the. Now read line, I'm executing this read line and it will show me the next. What will I do? I will again, suppose I'm not copying this, I'm again, then whole, then world is locked down due to COVID-19. If I again read line, using read line, what will it return? It will return me empty string. Now I am again seeking to the start of the file. By executing this cell. Now in case I have also, we are also provided with a read lines function. What does this read lines do? Read lines will read all the lines and make a list for us. It will give us a list. Then upon executing this cell, I have returned a list containing all the lines. Then I will seek again to the start of the file. Now I can use the while loop. I can use while loop for reading all the lines of file, and upon executing this cell, I have not got this because this D is got consumed in this read line. Now what can I do here? This I will show you next time. Then to read line by line using for loop, I can use this code. Firstly, I have to run this again. Seek, then using for loop, we can read and print line by line file. I have to comment this. This is the whole content of the file line by line. Then I have to execute f.seek to move to the start of the file. Then if I want to know how many words are there in the file, how many words are there in the file, this can be done by executing this 8. The 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Alright. How I am finding the words? I have read the whole content of the file and the string is returned in this data. Now data is referring to the string that is returned by this command. Then I have used the string function. Now data contains string. Now all the string functions that are there that we have learnt, namely count, find, replace, split, join, is upper, is lower, can be applied to these strings. I have applied data.split. Now if split is not provided any argument, it will split on the basis of spaces that are there and it will give us the list. Now on finding the length of the list, I will got the words that are there in the file. this is, now by executing this line I have closed this file. Now with the keyword, when we open a file using the with keyword, here the file handle is f. Now we don't explicitly close our file handle here. We don't provide f.close here. It is closed for us by with itself. Suppose we are executing this and this is the contents that are there in A1. Suppose I am changing this A1 to B1, then I got the content that is there in our file, and upon executing f.closed, it is returning me true, means the file is closed. Now if I want to write the data to a text file, how to write data to the text file? Firstly, I have to open a file, text file. I don't have to provide B here in the mode, and I have supplied write mode here because I have to write the data to the text file, and I want to write hello world, Python is amazing. Upon executing, I should got a file named A2 whose content is hello world, Python is amazing here, right? Now I have executed this help. Now what I am doing, I am copying the content of one file that is there in A1. So I am writing it B1. I am opening a file named B1, opening it in read mode. This is a text file opened in read mode. I read the data that is there in the file in data, and again I opened a file A3 as a text file in the write mode, and here I have written the content of the file B1 to this A3 file, and I closed both of these files. After executing this cell, I should got file A3 with the contents of B1. Now B1 contained the whole world is locked down due to COVID-19. Now I should got a file named A3 with the contents of B1. Upon inspecting, I have this file with the content of B1. Now upon executing the next cell, what is there in the next cell? Here I have opened a file A1 in the text mode using read mode, and A4 in the write mode for line in F. I am reading the line of A1 and writing it to A4. It is doing the same thing that was done before using line by line approach. Here I have read the whole content in one go, and in this cell I am writing the content using line by line approach. Upon executing this, I should got a file named A4 with the content of B1. I have not provided the A1 here, A1.
contents are viewed, close, then the content should be changed. These are the contents that are written from B1. Now upon executing this, I have a list of string. There is another write function provided to us, which is write lines. What does write lines does? Write line write the iterable to the file. I have supplied list, whole list, to this write lines, and write line is writing these to our file. Upon executing, I got the file named A5 with the content of this hello world. I am writing data to file. But there is no space in between. Then in the next cell, we opened a file named A6. In the as a binary file, because we have supplied here binary, and in the write mode with the read capabilities also. This is the update mode. This is the write mode. What we are doing, we are writing the contents of the file. Comment all these statements. We will execute them one by one. Now, upon executing this cell, we have opened A6 as a binary file in the write mode, and we are writing this string, this byte string. We note this B in front of this string. This means this string is byte string or byte stream. Byte string to the file A6. Now we should got a file named A6 with the contents. We have not got the contents. Why? Suppose, and what does this write returned? Write return the number of bytes written. Number of bytes written to the file. In case of characters, it returned the number of characters written. Then if we execute again, dot close, and open this file again, execute. Here is the string. Remember, there is no difference in the display of this content. We are not getting any 0101 here. We are dealing with binary modes, and it is done behind the scene for us. And these are the contents of our A6 file. Suppose we want, and we know the file object's current position is at the start of the file. If we read first three bytes,
then 0, 1 and 2 would got consumed. 0, 1 and 2 here would got consumed by this file. Suppose I am again executing this cell. Here I got P and let us write there is some error. There is the data. I need to get a new cell, and in here I copy these commands one by one. I will execute these commands one by one and try to get the output f.read3. Read of closed file, okay. Upon writing this, I got okay. What is the error here? Edit mode, control enter 16 return, then upon executing here we got, well, you are getting nothing here, f dot read a6. I am deleting this A6 for the time being here. Why it is not allowing me to delete? It might be used here. F6. Now can I delete this? Now this file got deleted. I will again execute this cell. Upon executing this cell, I should got A6 and with the contents, I got the contents and the file. Now I have to again open this file in the same mode. I will execute the code, and upon reading f.read3, I got this. Suppose I am reading this with this is so okay. I first have to seek to seek to this start of the file. Now in the command mode enter new cell. Then I have to provide this f.read. I will got here. What is the problem here? 3 bytes f.seek. to the start of the file. I have to show you how seek and read and tell works here, but this is not allowing me to. Suppose I open A6 and open it in read and binary. Right, I have written. Then I execute this code. Then again I read. Then what is here? Item 3. Okay. Why it is so? There is no data in the file. I will show you this in the next video. Now here I have opened a file img.png in the I have opened this file in the as a binary file in the read mode with the update capability. In this cell I have opened the file img.png, then I have read this file. And I have shown you the content of this file. To show you the content, as this is the image, I can show you the image. This is the image. Sorry. This is the image, and I have shown the content that is there. This is the binary file. Now, if I want to copy this file in another file, I have to read this file and opened another binary file, and line by line I can do this line by line or in the same go. Upon executing this cell, I should got a image by the name 1 minute EG1. EG1.png. EG1.png. This is the same file. then I will show you how to write how to read and write the CSV files. Suppose I have a CSV file by the name eggs2.csv, which I've shown you earlier. For this, we have to import CSV module. Then we open the CSV module and we have to supply it here read mode. If we are not applying this mode is there by default. New line, we have to supply it here. Then the file handle is f. Then we have to use this csv.reader function and supply this file handle. Then the delimiter, which is there in our CSV file, which is comma. Then we will print our CSV file. Then in case of writing CSV files, we need to import CSV module. Then we need to open this CSV file in the write mode, and we have to use csv.writer associate our file handle, delimiter, and we write, suppose we write hello. Here upon executing this line, we should got a CSV file by the name x4, which I will show you the notepad. I got this CSV file. Then there is pickle module in our pickle module. Now pickle, what does pickle do? Pickles and the Python data objects to binary streams. Pickling is the process to convert Python data objects to the binary stream, and unpickling is the process of reconverting the binary streams back to the Python objects. Now what can be pickled? These data types can be pickled. These are the various data objects that can be pickled in Python. And there is also a security concern. Suppose we got a pickled object from someone else, and if we unpickled it, it might contain the malicious code from the crafted programmer, which can harm our programmer system. Then for pickling, here I have written a code. I have imported the pickle module. This is the data object, complex number. Then I have opened the file where I need to store this data object. For storing the data object, there are two functions, dump and dumps. I have used dump here. I have dumped a data object to the file f, and again when I need to load from this file, I need to firstly read this file in the binary mode, then using the load function, I use the load, and b here I got this complex number. Then I close this file. Here what I am doing, this is the image file, and here the image file is written. Now this is the file handling. See you in the next class. Thank you.